time competing in the biannual International Amateur Salsa and Ballroom Dancing Championships in Paris.
You're getting on a plane, Mrs. Wormwood?
Of course, I always compete, Doctor. And this year I've got a secret weapon.
Rodolfo.
He's part Italian, you know. Very supple. He's got incredible upper body strength.
I think we should have a talk.
So what is it? What's wrong with me?
Mrs. Wormwood, do you really have no idea?
Gas?
Mrs. Wormwood, I want you to think very carefully. What do you think might be the cause of this?
Look. Look at my back!
Mrs. Wormwood,
you're pregnant!
What?
You're going to have a baby!
But I've got a baby, I do not want another one. Isn't there something you could do?
You're 9 months pregnant.
And it's a baby or oh my good lord. What about the biannual International Amateur Salsa and Ballroom Dancing Championships?
What are you looking at? A baby, Mrs. Wormwood. A child. The most precious gift the natural world can bestow upon us has been handed to you. A brand new human being. A life. A person. A wonderful new person is about to come into your life to bring love and magic and happiness and wonder.
I'm a special little light. Daddy says I'm a ball. Mommy says I'm a gentle little germ that kids like me should be against the law. My daddy says I should learn to shut my pie hole. No one likes a small mouth girl like me. Mom says I'm a good case for population control. Dad says I should watch more TV.
Yes, sir. That's right, sir. 155 brand new luxury car, sir. Oh, are they good runners? Oh, let me put it this way. You wouldn't have beat them in a race. No, sir. Yes, sir. They are good runners, sir. Exactly how much are we talking? Ah! Harry! Look at this. She is reading a book. I do not think it's normal for a 5-year-old to be reading. I think she might be in pity.
Listen to this. It was the best of times. It was the worst of times. It was the age of wisdom.
And she keeps trying to tell me stories, Harry. Stories, I mean. Who wants to hear stories? Girls should not be all thinking and stuff. I'm going to call you straight back. Would you please shut up? I am trying to pull off the biggest business deal of my life. I've got to listen to this. It's your fault. You're the one spending us into trouble. And you expect me to get us out of it? What am I, flaming escapologist?
Escapologist, he says. What about me then? I've got a whole ass to look after. Ninnas don't microwave themselves, you know. If you're an escapologist, then I must be an acrobat to balance with that lot. The world's greatest acrobat. Well, I'm off to bleach my roots. And I shan't be talking to you for the rest of the evening, you horrid little man.
But I'm going to make us rich.
Rich? How rich?
Very rich. Russian businessman. Very, very stupid. Your genius husband is going to sell them 155 knackered old bangers as brand new luxury cars.
But that's not fair. The cars will break down. What about the Russians?
Fair? Listen to that boy.
I'm a girl.
Fair doesn't get you anywhere, you thick-headed twit brain. All I can say is, thank heavens Michael hasn't had his old man's brains. Hey, son.
Michael!
Well, I shall take the money when you earn it, and I shall spend it. But I shan't enjoy it because of this despicable way in which you've spoken to me tonight.
This is your fault. With your stupid books and your stupid reading.
What was I doing to anything? That's not wrong.
Right? Not right? Oh, I'll tell you something. You're off to school in a few days' time. You won't be getting any ride there. Oh, no. You see, I know your headmistress, Agatha Trunchbull. And I've talked all about you and your smarty pants ideas. Great, big, strong, scary woman she is. You're going to beat the Olympics. Throw in the hammer. Imagine what she is going to do to a horrible, squeaky little goblin like you.
I'm a girl!
Now get off to bed, you little bookworm.
Subsequent fall wasn't there in trouble. begin with the flap of a wing. The tiniest mite packs the mightiest sting every day. Stops the tick of a clock, all escapes. Stops the click of a lock. You're stuck in your story, and once you get out, you don't have to cry. You don't have to shout. Cause if you're little, you can do a lot. You must let a little be like little stop me.
Matilda. And that's not a hint, by the way, but if you did happen to have a story...
Goodbye, Mrs. Phelps. See you next week.
Goodbye, Miss Honey, and good luck with the Tolstoy. As I was saying, Matilda, I'm not hinting, but if you did have a story you wanted to tell me...
Who is that lady?
That lady? That was Miss Honey. She's going to be your teacher.
That lady? This lady's mine.
Yes, your teacher. Now, are you going to tell me a story or not?
Once upon a time, the two greatest sex performers in the world, an escapologist, who's given a love for each other, which was so deep it was said that cats would purse past them and dogs would weep for joy. They moved into a beautiful old house on the edge of town, and in the evenings they would walk and take the air, and each night the children of the town would wait in anticipation, hoping for glimpses and the shiny white scarf that the acrobat always wore. For them, they knew they had only to cry, "Tricks, tricks!" and the great performers would instantly alight with the most spectacular show. Just for them. With all their love, they loved each other, although they were friends and everyone loved them. They were sad. Said the wife.
We have everything.
But we did not have the one thing in the world we want most.
But the one thing.
We do not have a child.
Patience, my love.
Patience, my love, the husband replied, but time is on our side. Even time loves us.
Oh, Matilda.
But time is the one thing no one is master of. It's time passed, they grew quite old and still had no child. At night, they would listen to the silence of the big empty house. They would imagine how beautiful it would be. It was filled with the sounds of a child playing.
Tilda, this is so sad.
Do you want me to stop?
Don't you dare.
Their sadness overwhelmed them, and you know, they won't let anyone take his place. And the work became the only place they could escape. Inescapable tragedy of their lives! And so it was. They decided to perform the most dangerous feat ever known to man.
It is cold,
said husband, announced the event to the workplace, who gathered to whisper bits of breath.
The burning woman hurling through the air with dynamite in her hand, and the shots in spiky objects caught by the hand locked in the cage.
It is the most dangerous feat ever known to man! It is our destiny, said his wife, smiling sadly and slipping her hand into his. It is where the loneliness of life has led us.
Well, what happened?
I don't know. Not yet, anyway.
Well, isn't there some more? At least a little bit? Well, I suppose your mother will be waiting for you. Is she here? I would love to meet her. Maybe...
By the salt, I'll see you tomorrow!
After your first day at school.
I am a princess.
Mom says I'm an angel.
isn't it? Please stand and do as much as you can.
1 times 2 is 2, 2 times 2 is 4, 3 times 2 is 6, 4 times 2 is 8, 5 times 2 is 10, 6 times 2 is 12, 7 times 2 is 14, 8 times 2 is 16, 9 times 2 is 18, 10 times 2 is 20, 11 times 2 is 22, 12 times 2 is 24.
My, that is very...
13 times 2 is 26, 14 times 2 is 28, 15 times 2 is 30, 16 times 2 is...
Stop! Good heavens, how far can you go?
I don't know. Quite a long way, I think.
Do you think you could tell me what 2 times 28 is?
56.
Well, yes, that's the... How about this? Now, this is much harder, so don't worry if you don't get it, but 2 times 478. If you took your time, do you think you could...
974?
Twelve sevens.
84.
Whoa! No way!
Let's leave maths for the time being and move on to reading. Now, can any of you read this?
Me! I know it!
Me! Give me! I know it!
Oh, Michael. Yes. I think we'd better leave it there, Nigel. We wouldn't want you to burst a blood vessel on your first day.
No fair.
Lavender?
Is the first word tomato?
No. But tomato is a very good word.
Yes.
Matilda?
I cannot read words.
So, Matilda, you can read words.
Well, yes. I needed to learn to read words so I could read sentences, because basically a sentence is just a big bunch of words. And, well, if you can't read sentences, you've got no track of books.
And have you read a whole book yourself, Matilda?
Oh, yes. More than one. I love books. Last week I read quite a few.
A few? In a week? My, that is very good. What books did you read?
Nicholas Nickleby, Oliver Twist, Jane Eyre, Tess of the Dabbleberries, The Lord of the Rings, Kim, The Invisible Man, Secret Garden, Crime and Punishment, and... Stick of the Dump.
She's a real warp.
Oh, no, Headmistress. I don't think Matilda's that kind of child at all.
What is the school motto, Miss Honey?
Bambinatum est magitum.
Bambinatum est magitum. Children are maggots. In fact, it must have been her who put that stink bomb under my desk this morning. I'll have her for that. Thank you for suggesting it.
But I didn't. Miss Trunchbull, Matilda Wormwood is a genius.
Nonsense! Haven't I just told you she is a gangster?
But she knows her times tables.
So she's learned a few tricks.
She can read.
So can I.
I have to tell you, Headmistress, that it is my opinion that this little girl should be placed in the top form with the 11-year-olds.
What? But she is a squib, a shrimp, an unhatched tadpole. We cannot simply place her in with the 11-year-olds. What kind of society would that be? What about rules, honey? Rules!
I believe that Matilda Wormwood is an exception to the rules.
An exception? To the rules. In my school! Look at my trophies, see how my trophies gleam in the sunlight, see how they shine. What do you think it took to become English hammer throwing champion? 1969! Do you think in that moment when my big moment came that I treated the rules with casual disdain? Well, like hell! As I stepped up to the circle, did I change my plan? What? As I chopped up my palms, did I wave my hands? I did not! As I started my spin, did I look above you? Did I drift on my dream for a minute or two? Did I get bolted or amended for occasion? Do you think I got through my intended elevation? As the hammer took off, did I change my grunt? The grunt I practiced for many a month. Not a dot, not a dot. Did I stray from the bluff? Not a detail of my throw, was I trusted or forgotten? Not even when the hammer left my hands. I sailed high up, up above the stand. Did I let myself go? No, 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 no. No.
Lovely.
Oh, stop!
Give it to me now!
Come on, you shit little brat.
Gibbet!
She's got no respect! It's all books and stories.
No!
No!
My sister wants to break!
Ah!
then your mother is a twit.
People like me are clever. It's very quaint. It's
and the volume with which what you don't know is expressed. Importance has never been less important. So you have got to be
what sort of teacher?
have a sister with a success and a love.
Okay, look, alright, I stole the cake.
thunder. And then my great big beautiful chocolatey bird, which now seemed to have a mind of its own, wafted full into the face of the trench wall.
Even me. Wow. Well done, Bob Trotter. Good show.
I would like to offer an apology for some of the things that have been going on here tonight. Now, they are not nice things, and they are not right things. And I would like to state, guarantorically, that we do not want any children that might be here tonight watching this to go home and try these things out for themselves. I am, of course, talking about reading books. It is normal for kids to behave in fashion. It stunts the brain, wears out the eyes, makes kids ugly, stinky, fatty, sweaty, betty, boring, gaseous, and, crucially, gives them the raucous of the mind. Under no circumstances do we condemn such activities, and we do so utterly without reservoir. Now, can I just ask, how many people here have ever read a book? Let's be honest, for tomorrow. Oh my good lord, you've all gone mad. No, no, keep them up. Come on, stay with me here. You there, what's your name? Ian? Well, Ian, don't take this the wrong way, but... Bookworm, bookworm, stupid little bookworm, reading all his books like a stupid little bookworm. You read books like a worm. Worms read books. Worms are stupid. You're a swim. There, now Ian will learn from that. Won't stop him from reading, unfortunately. But he'll never put his hands up in the theatre again. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, may I present to you today the pinnacle of our achievements as a species, the very reason we bothered calling out unicorns in the first place. Somewhere, on a show, I heard that a picture tells a thousand words. So telly, if you bothered to take a look, is the equivalent of like lots of books. All I know I learned from this big, beautiful box of facts. And if you know a thing already, baby, you can switch the channel over just like that. Endless joy and endless laughter, folks living happily ever after. All you need to make you wise is 23 minutes plus advertisements. Why would we waste our energy turning the pages 1, 2, 3 when we could sit comfortably on a lovely bump of bleach watching people singing and talking and doing stuff? All I know I learned from
time.
The bigger the
time,
the smarter the man. And you can tell from my big
time
just how clever of a feather I am. Take it away, son. Can't learn that from a stupid book. All I know I learned from
time.
What to think and what to buy. Now I was pretty smart already, but now I'm really, really smart. Very, very smart. Endless content, endless panels, endless chat on endless panels. All you need to fill your muffin without having really think or nothing. Why would we waste our energy trying to work out Ulysses when we can sit comfortably on a lovely bump of these, watching certain famous people talking to really famous people? All I know I've learned from
time.
The bigger the
time,
the smarter the man. And you can tell from my big
time
just how clever of a feller I am. Who the dickens is Charles Dickens? Mary Shelley, or she sounds smelly. Charlotte Bronte, do not want it. Jane Austen, in combustion. James Joyce, we didn't sound nice. Ewan McEwan, I feel like spewing. William Shakespeare, Shmellium Shakespeare. Moby Dick. Hey, easy grandma. All together now!
All I know I learned from
Telly!
The bigger the
Telly!
The smarter the man.
Lord.
by the way, Matilda's best friend. There's a book coming up that's all about me. Well, not exactly about me, but I play a big part in it. But I'm not going to say what happens because I don't want to spoil it for you. All right, look, what I do is I volunteer to get the Trunchbull a jug of water, and then... No! I will not say any more because I don't want to hurt it! Well, on the way back, I find a newt. A newt is like a really ugly lizard that lives in water. So I pick it up, and no! I will not say any more! I'm gonna put the new Trunchbull's water. It's gonna be brilliant!
lovely to see you. Are you enjoying school?
Oh, yes. Bits of it, anyway. Miss Phelps, where is the revenge section?
We don't have a revenge section, dear. Why? Is there a child at school who's behaving like a bully?
Oh, no, not a child, exactly.
Matilda, are you sure something's not
wrong? Do you want to hear the next part of the story?
Story? Did you say story? Matilda, what are we waiting for? With a child like you?
Oh yeah, they do. They're always saying that. In fact, they say, You're so proud of me, Matilda. You're like when they laughed at me. Yeah, I better go.
I'm so clever. I'm so very, 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 very clever. I'm so very flaming clever. What a very, very clever of a fitter I am. Come here, you. Stop.
Stop. There is only one man I do that with.
Everyone, gather round. I want my family to share my triumph. Not you, boy.
I'm a girl.
155 old bangers on my hands. All polished up with the mileage on the clock telling the truth that each one was knackered. How could I possibly make the mileage go back? Couldn't very well drive each one backwards, now could I?
Backwards.
When suddenly I had the most genius idea in the world. I run into the workshop, grabbed my drill, and using my incredible mind, attached the drill to the speed meter thingy on the first car and whacked it into reverse.
Backwards!
Yes, boy. Backwards. Words. Backwards, exactly. A drill's motor whirls backwards thousands of times a second, so within a few minutes I reduced the mileage on that old rust bucket to practically nothing. I did it to every single car.
Backwards?
Yes, that's right. Stop talking now, darling. There's a good boy.
10 minutes later, the Russian chew up. Great big nasty face apes. Expensive suits, dark glasses. Don't know who they thought they were.
Russians are... nocturnal. I saw on a program last night.
That was badgers. It was a program about badgers.
Same thing. And did it work?
Fantastico!
Now I can afford Rodolfo all day long.
But you've cheated them. That's not fair at all. They trusted you. And you've cheated them.
What's wrong with you? What have we done to deserve a child like you?
Do you know what I'm going to do tomorrow? I'm going to go down to that library and tell that old bag that she'll never to be let in again.
What? No, please don't!
And if she does, I will have her fired. You will never read another stinking book as long as you live. I will put an end to your stories, young man. Now get out of my face, you nasty little creep!
So wrapped
to my life.
The scent, a revolt,
the rink of insubordination. Our brother systems, the pawn of extension, the book of mutiny and action.
That's not right!
For a weed becomes stupid and greedy, you really need to nip it in the bud. Position two! Before the worm starts to turn, you must scrape off the dirt and rip it from the mud. A whiff of insubordination, the stench of intent, the reek of prepubescent protest, the pound of defiance, the odor of you, the warmth of anarchy and progress. Once we've exorcised these demons, they shall be too pooped for scheming. Some double time discipline should stop the rod from setting in. All right, let's step it up. Double time. 1, 2, 3, 4, discipline, discipline for till the door, listening for midgets who are fidgeting and whispering and history. They're tattering and tittering, nattering and twittering, is tempered with a smattering of discipline. We must begin insisting on your dignity and discipline, persistently resisting his anarchist from mischievous. These minutes are perjuring, are battering and pitying, while they learn like there's no just no discipline. The simpering and whispering and the trembling and the spiggling, the misunderstanding and tissue is an issue. We get fixed with no mystery to mastering the art of your mischievous discipline.
Yeah.
still travel away from us. At the full speed of light, which drives in our way, I'm trying to stay in short, but I want it inside my head. You're just a bit different from some of my friends. These answers that come into my mind forbidden, these stories delivered to me fully fit. A man even shouts like they seem to like shouts. The noise in my head is incredibly loud, and just boosting stuff in my dad and my mum. And they're telling if stories would stop at swords. And I'm sorry, I'm not quite explaining it right. But the noise becomes anger, the anger is light. It's burning inside me, where do you leave?
What do you think it is? This thing with my eyes?
I can't can't pretend to know, Matilda, but I don't believe that we should be afraid of it. I think it has something to do with that incredible mind of yours.
You mean there's no room on my head for all my bones today? I have to squish out of my eyes!
Well, no, not exactly, but yes, something like that, I suppose. You really are a special girl, Matilda. I met your mother. He's unusual. What about your father? Is he proud to have a daughter as clever as you?
Oh yeah, very. He's very proud. He's very, very, very proud. He's always saying, Matilda, I'm very proud to have a daughter as... That's not true, Miss Honey. That's not what he says. He's not proud at all. He calls me a liar, a cheat, and a nasty little creep!
I see. Well, here we are, home sweet home.
Are you Paul?
Yes, very. Come sit.
Don't they pay teachers very much?
Well, they don't, actually, but I am even poorer than most for, well, other reasons. You see, I used to live with my aunt, but one day I was out walking, and I came upon this old shed. I fell completely in love with it. I ran to the farmer and begged him to let me move in. He thought I was mad, but he agreed, and I've lived here ever since.
Mama told me you can't live in a shed!
I'm not strong like you are, Matilda. You see, my father died when I was young. Magnus was his name. He was very kind. But when he was gone, my aunt became my legal guardian. She was mean and cruel like you can hardly imagine. And when I got my job as a teacher, she presented me with a bill for looking after me all those years. She'd written everything down. Every tea bag, every electricity bill, every tin of beans. And she made me promise to pay her back every penny. She even produced a document saying that my father had given her his entire house.
But did he really do that? Magnus, I mean. Did he really give her his house?
I don't know, Matilda, but I find it hard to believe. Just like I cannot believe that he would have killed himself, which is what she said had happened.
You think she did him in, don't you, Miss Honey?
I don't know, Matilda. All I know is that years of being bullied by that woman have made me, well, pathetic. I was trapped.
So that's why you live here?
This roof keeps me dry when the rain falls. This door helps to keep the cold at bay. On this floor, I can stand on my own 2 feet. On this chair, I can write my lessons. On this pillow, I can dream my nights away. And this table, as you can see, well, it's perfect for tea. It isn't much, but it is enough for me. It isn't much, but it is enough. On these walls I hang wonderful pictures. Window, I can watch the seasons change. By this lamp, I can read. And I am set free. And when it's cold outside, I feel no fear. Even in the winter storms, I am warmed by a small but stubborn fire. And there is much. isn't much, but it is enough for me. It isn't much, but it is enough for me.
Miss Honey, is this your father's scarf?
Yes, my mother gave it to him before she died. You see, she was
an acrobat?
Yes. How did you... And my father? Well, he was an...
An escapologist?
Matilda, how do you know that?
So, they were your parents!
What? Who?
The people in my story!
What story?
A story! I've been telling a story! I thought I was making it up! But it's real! It's your life! I've seen your life!
You've seen my life?
She did him and left... Let's go to the police!
Matilda, no! Stop! We have no evidence!
But you could just tell them she did it!
But it would be my word against hers, and she would never believe that she was capable of murder!
But why? She was so cruel to you! She beat you, she shouted at you, she locked you up in tiny cupboards and threw you into cellars!
Matilda, stop, please!
Miss Honey, your aunt's a murderer! She killed Magnus! Who is she?
Contract!
Huh? Miss Trunchbull! But if I play by the rules and I do not win, then something is wrong. Something is not working. And when something is wrong, you have to put it right, even if it screams. What are you looking at?
You.
This class is going to have a very special spelling test. And any child who gets one answer wrong shall go to choking. Yep! Spell. Oh no, let me see. Spell Newt.
Newt! N-E-W-T! Newt!
What?
Miss Honey taught us she's very good at teaching.
Nonsense! Miss Honey is too soft and peachy to be good at anything! Any moron can see that! Yo! Stand up, turn around, and spell the one thing that you all are. Revolting!
Revolting. R-E-V-O-L-T-I-N-G. Revolting.
You're cheating!
Of course she's not cheating. She's simply spelling the word.
These little specks of dust cannot be this clever. They are worms.
I've taught them. That's all. With kindness. Kindness and patience and respect.
How dare you bring those words into my classroom, madame? You know nothing of teaching and I shall prove it. Yeah, spell. Angelicuminosepticolostomosis.
What? But that's not a word. You just made it up.
Spell or go to Chucky. And I should warn you, it has silent letters.
A-M-C-H-E-L-L-A.
Oh dear, oh dearie, dearie, dear. I'm so sorry, it was a silent Z. You're going to choking!
Banana, G-T-A-A-B-L. Banana.
few days later, the acrobat and the escapologist's daughter received a letter from a solicitor. It said that her parents' will had mysteriously turned up, and she was now the owner of a beautiful old home, which had up until that moment belonged to the evil aunt, one Agatha Trunchbull. She moved in immediately, and she was very happy, happier than she had ever been in her entire life.
As for Miss Trunchbull, well, she was never seen again. The Chokies were immediately destroyed, and a new headmistress took over.
And her name was Miss Honey. And it was often said that it was the best school in all the land.
Do you know something else? Matilda never again could move things with her mind. I thought perhaps it was because her mind was being challenged, but she said it was because she no longer had a need for superpowers. But sometimes, I would look at this little girl. This little girl who had done so much to help others, but who was stuck with parents who were mean and cruel and called her names, and my blood would just boil. And I would wish that I could just do something.
So, this is the end. And I wish so much that I could tell you that this story has a happy ending. I wish so much that I could tell you that Matilda got the love she deserved. But I guess the truth is, not all stories have happy endings.
Don't just stand there whopping! We're going to Spain!
Spain, but why?
Because this idiot, this nit, this twit brain decided to sell 155 bangers to the Russian Mafia.
I didn't know they were the flaming Russian Mafia now, did I? Come on, boy, we're leaving forever and we're never coming back.
Wait! Let Matilda stay here with me.
I beg your pardon.
I will care for her with love and respect and kindness and I will pay for everything.
You mean leave our daughter here with you?
What did you say? Did you call me your...
Oh, come on, don't stand here. We gotta go. They're gonna be here any minute.
Dad! You call me your daughter.
See, they're here, I told you.
Hide in the books.
What if they damage my legs? My beautiful legs!
You are the Wermut's daughter?
Yes.
Where is your father?
I don't know.
The Wermut is a stupid man. Being stupid as he assumed here, I was stupid too. And that is a very stupid and a rude thing to do. What is your name, little girl?
Matilda.
I like you, Matilda. You seem smart. Sadly, in my line of work, I don't often get to meet smart people like you. Most of the people I meet, their thinking is all backward.
Backwards!
Only that I pokri bias by ever. That's all it's up. Da, priano was not who meets us to go in my the bochkoi.
Spasiba, manchise pria, as not who meets us, zvami.
Ty говоришь по-русски?
I tak хорошо, как вы меня отелас, и так красивый язык. А там я буду стараться изучать его дальше.
Matilda, who taught you how to speak Russian?
Well, I taught myself, I suppose. I was reading Dostoevsky, and I just thought that would be better to read in the language of written in.
I am Sergei. Matilda, it is truly an honor to meet you. Say, your father has been stupid and rude to both of us. Yes? I can very easily have one of my friends teach him some manners, and one day when he leaves the hospital, he will still be stupid, but not so rude, I think. I give this as a gift to you. What do you say?
Mr. Sergei, this is a very tempting offer, but he's my father and I'm his daughter. I think I've had enough of revenge.
Party pooper. But this little girl, this miracle, Matilda.
No, don't you delay.
Я тебе бы сказала это.
Matilda! Я сказал, Matilda! Что с вами сегодня?
Извините,
Matilda, your father is clearly a very stupid man. But he's also very, 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 very lucky to have you as his daughter. Although, if I happen to be doing business here again, and I see him, he'll not be so lucky.
Okay, let's get out of here before they change their minds.
What about the girl? You want to stay here with Miss Honey?
Yes, yes, I do!
And do you actually want to look after her?
I do.
Well, I mean, we are a bit short of room, so yeah.
Thank you!
And Matilda leapt into Miss Honey's arms!
And I hugged her! And she hugged back.
And they hardly noticed as the Wormwoods... and Rodolfo. As the Wormwoods and Rodolfo sped away into the distance.
Because they had found each other.
Yes, they had found each other.
Come on, you.